The Prime Minister and the BJP said that the Congress party has done nothing in 70 years. There is a list here of all the assets that the Congress party has helped build. These assets have been built using public money, thousands and thousands of crores of rupees over the last 70 years. Now the Prime Minister is in the process of selling the crown jewels of this country. I'm going to read what is being sold, and you can guess to which monopolist it is being sold. Frankly, this entire list is going to go to only three or four people. And these are the sectors that those three or four people are interested in. So, roads, 1.6 lakh crores, 26,700 kilometers of national highways. Railways, 1.5 lakh crores, 400 stations, 150 trains, railway tracks and woodsheds. Power transmission, 42,300 circuit kilometers of transmission network. Power generation, 40,000 crores, 6,000 megawatts of hydro, solar, wind assets. Natural gas pipeline, 25,000 crores, 8,000 kilometers of GAIL pipeline. Petrol pipeline, 4,000 kilometers, Indian Oil and HPCL pipelines, 22,000 crores. Telecom, 35,000 crores, 2.86 lakh kilometers of BharatNet fiber optics. Warehousing, 29,000 crores, 210 lakh metric tons of food storage. Who is this designed to hurt? This is designed to hurt our farmers. This is designed to make sure that one person gets a monopoly in the agricultural system of India. Mining, 20,000 crores, 160 coal mines. Airports, 21,000 crores, 25 airports. You know who the airports are going to, who they've been going to. These 25 will also go there. Ports, 13,000 crores, 31 projects, 9 ports, you know who that is going to go to. Stadiums, 11,000 crores, 2 national stadiums. So this is what is being given away, what is being gifted. Right? There is an excuse they've come up with that we are leasing this. Let's suppose you give 25 airports, right? And you are helping create a monopoly of one person owning all the airports. Fine, 40 years later we have a discussion, but by that time the game is over. Right? So it is not a question of whether it is being sold or it is being partially sold. It is a question of control. You're giving them full control for 40 years to do whatever they want. You think 26,700 kilometers of national highway is languishing in this country? Where? There's not a single national highway that's languishing. Go anywhere, it's full. Road sector is not languishing. Railway sector is not languishing. Power transmission sector is not languishing. Mining sector is not languishing. Telecom sector is not languishing. Warehousing is not languishing. So where, what is she talking about? Which sector here is languishing? Even stadiums are not languishing. So now you're telling me that roads are not being utilized? That by giving it to a private person, the road will suddenly start getting utilized? It's getting utilized right now, right? You're telling me railway trains in India are not getting utilized? You're telling me power generation, natural gas pipelines not getting utilized? Thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of crores have been put into that to create that asset. Now you're going to take a little bit of rent from that asset and you're going to give the asset to these people. And what's going to happen after 40 years? Who knows? Who knows what's going to happen after 40 years? Now, the government clearly has mishandled the economy. The government clearly does not know what to do. They have basically destroyed what the UPA built. And now, as a last resort, they are selling everything that we had helped create. We have dealt earlier with a monopoly in India. It used to be called the East India Company. Right? It enslaved this country. It was basically a monopoly. That is what is happening now. We are heading into enslavement. So that is something that has to be understood. Demonetization, GST, the way they designed it, is designed to do two things. Number one, it is designed to kill the informal sector, destroy the informal sector. Because an informal sector person, if you do demonetization, he doesn't have the cash flow to save his business. His business dies. You can go and ask any small person, small businessman, that if you give him a shock like demonetization, he can't survive. And GST, as it is designed today, is essentially a tax on small and medium businesses. It is targeted to hurt them by making them formalize themselves at tremendous cost. Whereas a large company has no problem. Large company can hire 5 or 10 accountants and say, you know, we'll fill GST. But that individual, shopkeeper or mithai wala or person who's running a small shop, he doesn't have the infrastructure to get those accountants. So he just dies. So those two ideas were to destroy the informal sector. The three farm laws are to destroy the informal sector in agriculture and to ensure that monopolists can come into that sector. Mr. Modi believes that large monopolists can transform this country. He does not realize that when you create such large monopolies, you cannot give jobs to people. And when you cannot give jobs to people, it leads to social tension, social anger, and then social explosion. Right? So you will see a dramatic increase in violence. You will see a dramatic increase in anger. You will see millions of youngsters who simply cannot have a future. And they will look at the houses of these monopolists and they will wonder what went wrong with India. That's what is happening. Mr. Modi is not the Prime Minister of India, he's an instrument. He is doing a particular job for these people.